And my name is Bruce Mitchell. I've designed and built the first 6-star certified industrial state in Australia. It's carbon neutral, by the way. We have our own water and sewer system. But I want to answer these other questions in regard to the power energy. I was very pleased to see that Trent's been in touch with EMO, the Australian Energy Market Organisation. I, in fact, have had a meeting at the board level. I've tried to introduce the biometric system, and I had one of the sheds in Melbourne that Mark works for, the company called Bellows, designed to put a 5-megawatt system, and the system was to put 1,730 individual households around Melbourne, whereby the biometric system could solve the problem, being on high rise, and answer the question. You could put on a residential rental property, you could bequeath it to one of your relatives, sons, and transfer the system anywhere you wanted to, from 11th story to 12th or 14th story building. All the systems would not be on the building, it would be on a house building. And the whole house building would then be set up in such a way that we could do this right around the whole country. It solves an economical problem. In fact, what happens in this case, there'll be no finance needed because someone wants a 4 or 5 kilowatt system on the house. They buy the unit, it's located in another building. It's insured for 20, 30 years. The whole system works. So I talked to EMO, designed it, talked to EMO, and they said their computer system couldn't cope with the biometric system which I set up. I then took it to England, and I went right through there, and they dropped the rebate scheme over there. So I came back, and now with the offset system they've got here, so you can use all your electricity during the day, run your washing machines, and offset it. Now this system would then read your meter at home, solve your problem because it would offset. It doesn't disfigure the buildings, doesn't disfigure beautiful architectural buildings. You have no panels on your roof, but it's located where the load is. So what happens in these factories, these old factories are actually in fact located right near where the loads are, so there's no voltage drop loss. The problem you've got with major solar farms around the country that are developing overseas, particularly in Italy and Spain, they have a huge voltage drop problem. In this system, it's right where the load is. The Chevrolet, for example, will cover all their power needed for the whole day. Now to overcome, outside of that, to overcome what we call the high energy use between 5 o'clock and 8 o'clock at night, I sat down with EMO and they said to me, we can bring in aggregated generators. Now there's quite a lot of generators in the country, by the thousands. They're not registered to run on power supply, they only run for emergency. Electricity is governed by electrical supply, supply and demand by the London Stock Exchange. And what happens in that case is sometimes the power gets up to $500 to $600 a kilowatt, split seconds, but during the peak power time, it gets expensive. That's when you put these aggregated generators into use, General Motors and a whole lot of them around the country. And they can then give 24-hour service to our power needs without any more power generating companies being set up. It's an exciting program, but EMO said that another 5 years before the computer system, we'd better cope with it. So it would be great if, for example, Trent and I could get together and go back to EMO and sit down and work this program out, because it will solve all the high-rise office complexes, it will solve all the residences and high-rises. So,
thank you.